John. Big John.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6 foot six and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John, Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. He didn't say much, he kind of quiet and shy. And if you spoke at all, you just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Then came the day at the bottom of the mine when a timber cracked and men started crying. Miners were praying and hearts beat fast, and everybody thought that they'd breathed their last except John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell walked a giant of a man that the miners knew well, grabbed a sagging timber and gave out with a groan, and like a giant oak tree just stood there alone, Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
And with all of his strength he gave a mighty shove. Then a miner yelled out, "There's a light up above." And 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. And now there's only one left down there to save, Big John. With Jackson timbers they started back down. Then came that rumble way down in the ground. And the smoke and gas belched out of that mine. Everybody knew it was the end of the line for Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Now they never reopened that worthless pit. They just placed a marble stand in front of it. These few words are written on that stand. At the bottom of this mine lies a big, big man. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
And hello, everybody. It's the 23rd episode of the Big John Show. We've been doing this for over a year now with something to talk about and the podcast. I tell you, we're getting out there, and we appreciate everyone that takes the time to listen to us. We really do. That means a lot. Let's see here. Next Tuesday, we'll be back at Raising Cane's. Can't wait to talk with Coach Phillips, whoever is our player of the game that Monday night, on the 7th. I know it's the national championship night, but we're going to be playing basketball. I've done moved on to basketball. I have. I can't wait for basketball season. I'm in basketball mode, full swing now. And so it's very exciting. I love basketball. I'm going to start watching more basketball today. Me and my wife's going to hang out. We're on this healthy kick. Trying to have a baby. So any kind of tips you can give me to get healthy, I want to hear about them. I do. So let's talk about that some this week and next. And we're going to get different people, get their advice, and you know, we may have them on the show, so we'll see. We'll see how that comes out. I'll be working on that. So that's what we're going to plan on doing. You know, because I want to get healthier, to have a family, and lose weight. I mean, I don't want to say lose weight to my New Year's resolution, because let's face it, you know, the gyms, I'm sure, are overcrowded this morning, and you're like, oh, damn, I wish this heifer would get out of the way. You know, when you've been going for a while, they won't be there in 3 months, I promise you. You know, that's just how it is. And I don't mean that in a negative way. I'm just keeping it real, people. Because you know me, I speak my mind on a lot of stuff. And I thank you for listening. And, you know, I got to do it. I got to mention these fine people. Raising Cane's of Laurel. Go by there for lunch or supper today. Kim's Nissan and Laurel, I tell you what, there's some great people to do business with. Circle L Farm Supply in Bay Springs. Wow. They've got some great feed for your livestock. Go by there and see the gang there. Southern Lace Boutique Apparel. Valentine's Day is right around the corner, guys, so be thinking about that. Sweet Blossoms Apparel. Go by Southern Lace, get your gift. Go to Sweet Blossoms, get your flowers. Wow. Convenient. They're in Apparel. Flicka's Tax Service in Taylorsville. Go by and see Miss Flicka. Tax season is going to be here, too. Park Place Pharmacy and Pedal, Brent Lindley and the gang. Man, they've got some great stuff. And go by there and see Brent. They've also got a gun shop in the store. So while you wait on your medicine to get done, you can go check out some, you know, guns. Glocks. They carry the Glocks. So see those guys. They're not doing it anymore. So sorry about that one. Trussell Tax Service in Hattiesburg, always fun to deal with and great people. Brad does a great job there. And Eve Marie's Boutique in Hattiesburg, great stuff, right across from CVS Pharmacy. And I got to tell you about this. National Tax Centers, man, they've got a great new office location right beside Central Sunbelt Federal Credit Union. Go by there and see them, and they will hook you up and get it done, get your taxes done at a reasonable rate, and you can also win a car. You have a chance at winning a car. I'm not going to say you're going to win it. You have a chance to win it. That's all I'm saying. Talking points. Okay, the first thing is this. Watched the bowl games yesterday, and you know that there wasn't any big surprises other than the fact that Mississippi State got it handed to them by Iowa. I wasn't expecting that one. I'm going to be honest with you. I thought Iowa was going to come in there and you know just lay down. But listen, Iowa's tough. You know, Iowa's one of those teams that have always been tough in the Big Ten. I'm not going to make up any kind of excuses saying, well, the referees did this and the referees did that. Oh, no, I'm not going to do that. What I am going to say is that we should have played a lot smarter football. Iowa did. And that's why they're the Outback Bowl champions and everybody's getting coconut shrimp today. You know? That's just the way it is. Mississippi State lost 27-22. Texas beat Georgia 28-21. So does that mean Texas should be in the college football playoff? Come on. Georgia got manhandled. Ohio State beat Washington 28-23. Sent Urban Meyer out on his retirement. LSU, thank you, LSU, for beating UCF so we don't have to hear that all year.
Well, UCF, they deserve to be in the playoff. They deserve it. Oh, we've got our make-believe playoff national championship like Ole Miss does. Oh.
Give me a break. Just UCF, go hide somewhere. Go hide. How about Kentucky beating Penn State 27-24? Scored 17 points in the third quarter to beat them. Wow. That is incredible. There's only one game left, and that's going to be on Monday. Alabama, 14-0, versus Clemson, 14-0. Alabama is a six-point favorite. You know, Alabama here, I don't think you can say anything about it. You know, I just think they're going to win. I think they've got it, plain and simple. Alabama has all the tangibles. They do. Somebody asked me the other day, said, John said, do you think Alabama needs to go on probation? I'm like, what for? Well, they're cheating. No, they're not. Alabama doesn't have to cheat. The name Alabama sells itself. I mean, it really does. The tradition that Alabama have sells itself. You know, I mean, it really does. But that's just the way what I think. We're going to take a break and come back, and we're going to talk more. We're going to talk about some interesting news stuff, so be on the lookout for that. Thanks for listening.
Gone, move along, just to make it through.